Now, if you've been a reader of mine or follow my stuff, you know one of my favorite movies recently was Graduate XXX Parody. I have gone on and on. I think it's movie of the year. There's one person I really wanted to interview, and that's India Summer. She played the Mrs. Robinson character in the movie. Thank you so much for taking time to talk to us.
Thanks for having me again. You guys are awesome.
Oh, she's awesome. I wish you could see her in person, honestly. Just jump right in. Let's start with the Graduate XXX.
Sure.
How was it working with Paul Thomas? I know that we're big fans of him. How was it working with
him? It was amazing. That was the first time I'd actually worked directly with him on a film, and he was great. I mean, at first I was really, really nervous because it's Paul Thomas.
Yeah.
And I've never worked with him, obviously, and he just kind of wanted you to do your thing at first, and if he saw anything wrong, maybe he'd say something to you, you know, and then you just redirect. He kind of just let you do your thing, and he has told me that he is so absolutely thrilled with this movie that when he called me and left that message, I was just like, oh, thank you, I'm so glad. You know, Paul's happy, hopefully everyone else is going to be happy, so I loved it, I had a blast. Anthony was amazing. So it was a big chore to take on. It's The Graduate. I mean, it's one of my favorite movies. It's a classic of all time, in my opinion. So it was huge for me.
Yes. You know what? Now that, I just remembered a question.
Yes.
And someone could back me up.
Someone.
There's a scene where you're tied up.
The girl, oh, yes, yes.
Yes.
Veronica Avlo. Fabulous, right?
One of the hottest scenes I've ever seen.
Good.
I was just like,
that was totally on the fly. This is Paul Thomas, because you show up for the day and you think you know what you're going to do, and you have no idea. So he's like, oh, let's do a BDSM scene with Mrs. Bancroft. And I'm like, okay, well, I guess that's what we're going to do. So it was on the fly, and there were ropes involved, and it was super fun.
Because I noticed that movie was very unconventional as far as different scenes and some things involved with the hot weapon. Because like, not only was it funny, but it was serious. You captured, when I interviewed Paul, he did give you more, he was brave about
so
it.
So kind.
And I agree with everything. But I was like, you know, the movie really evoked the emotions and the feelings of the original, which is what a parody should be.
Yes,
so,
I agree.
Awesome as a song.
Thank you.
You know, when they told you or offered you the role, what were your feelings for that? Nervous?
I was terrified. I think PT's PA had called me, who I know personally, and he said, you know, PT wants you to come audition for this. And I assumed, like, every girl was going to jump at this. I mean, it's The Graduate. So I'm like, oh my god, it has to be perfect. I have to have the right, like, Mrs. Robinson dress, and I have to take my cigarette, and I have to do my hair, and I have to wear my blue eyeshadow. So I went down to his place, and I was so nervous, and I just nailed the lines, and he's like, that was perfect. And I was like, yes! So how many girls are auditioning for this? Who do I have to beat up? And he's like, you're it. So, yes. I know one girl he was talking about who, you know, wanted to see if she wanted it, but no, that was it.
I can't imagine.
Thank goodness.
Anybody else. Really, you captured me.
Yes, thank you.
I'm gushing way too much about this, but I'm so excited.
I'm very excited. I wish that it was up for some things this year, but I guess that leaves room for next year.
That's right. Absolutely, absolutely. You've been very busy. I know.
Extremely.
This came out. How was that? How did you feel about actually calling the shots?
It was awesome. I loved calling the shots. That was my favorite part. To do it for Girlfriends was a blessing because Dan was able to take me under his wing and they ran the camera, so I didn't have to learn anything technical. And I know how Girlfriends is. I know what kind of product they want, so I was able to write a script that kind of invoked Girlfriends films. And they shot it. I hired the most amazing girls. I got to choose the talent, so I knew they were going to bring some hot scenes for me. And everyone just did an amazing job. It was interesting directing and being in the film at the same time. And the hardest part was actually having to watch the sex scenes from behind the camera. That was the first time I had to do that. And I was like, oh, I just want to get in there. But they didn't stay behind the camera. So it was really, really awesome. And I hear that the fans are really enjoying it. So I'm looking forward to doing a second one here in the next couple of months.
I honestly think you guys have some of the best fans. I mean, with the calendar,
they're so
everything,
dedicated.
I'm always hearing stuff on Twitter.
They love us, yes.
So,
And I feel like we give out a really good product, and so if it's obvious to show me.
Oh, absolutely. As far as board directing, is that something you're going to continue doing?
It is. Obviously, I'm going to do some more with Girlfriends Films, and I'm also working on my own production company, and I have some pretty big features in mind that I'd like to get done, so very soon, I hope.
Maybe you'll do a Graduate XXX sequel, I don't know.
I don't know.
I'll talk
never
to
say never.
I'll talk about it. I also know you have some 4 awards this
year.
Yes. I know it says MILF of the Year. I always see this. Listen, you're up there with all the other people.
I am. There are some amazing ladies on that list.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
I didn't put you with the big all-one category.
Thank you.
So,
I heard I was the most hired female talent of the year. So I was very, very busy this year.
Well, you know, it's funny because as you mentioned that, I remember I was watching the Wet Dream on Elm Street.
Oh, yes, I didn't get to see it. I was
and
devastated.
I was so surprised, but I was like, hey, what you doing here? It actually was hilarious. Like, it was a really funny thing. So,
I did not see it.
Yeah, you were very good at it.
In what?
No,
I was not in it. I was so sad.
Wait a minute. Where's this? A film that you're in that I was very surprised that you were in.
God only knows.
It was in a school room. I thought you might be a school teacher.
Oh, that's about a million.
Yeah, so. You know what? I'll try to read the correction at the bottom. There was something in there I was very surprised.
There was it was Seth Gamble. I don't know if you know male talent.
Yes, I mean, it was.
Yes.
Remember that?
Yes, I had a very small role, and now I can't think of the name of it. It was an assassin movie.
It was for the, now we're getting into
the adult
features. Adult features, the student assassin.
Yes, yes.
That's what it was.
That's what it was. That was fun.
Sorry, I watched too much. It gets all jumbled in there.
You're telling me. I shoot too much.
No. It was so funny. I saw it. It was a little segment. I was
yes,
like,
it was very fun. Just show up, boss around,
as far as 2012,
yes.
What do you got on your plate?
I got a lot on my plate. Obviously, I'm going to do my second movie for Girlfriends and maybe the third and some other things. Again, I'm working on my website ferociously. It's going to happen.
That by itself is fun.
Yes, and getting my own company going, so I never know.
And of course, follow her on Twitter,
yes.
Ms. India Summer. Just awesome. I mean, honestly, I can't say enough. One of my favorites in the business. I mean, it's only bias. I know it's not good for journalists to do that. So thank you so much.
Thank
all
you.
The best to you. Good luck in everything.
Yeah.
Check her out, please. Talk to you later.